China in the treatment of Indonesia and Macedonia in dysfunctional activity, a randomized comparative study. So coming to the introduction, we know that menstrual disorders, they affect a large number of women in the society, causing significant morbidities. And in that also, menorrhagia and dysmenorrhea are important menstrual disorders. Now, as far as menorrhagia is concerned, there are many causes of menorrhagia, but sometimes the cause of menorrhagia in about 50% of the patients of menorrhagia remains unknown. And such a condition is known as dysfunctional uterine bleeding. So according to guidelines and other guidelines, NSAIDs can be used as effective first-line treatment for the treatment of menorrhagia in dysfunctional uterine bleeding. This is according to number of guidelines. I've put it in nice guidelines over here. The NSAIDs are particularly useful when the menorrhagia is associated with dysmenorrhea, because then NSAIDs will be able to have both the ways. As far as NSAIDs are concerned, it has been seen that mefenamic acid is the most commonly studied agent in menorrhagia. And this has created a perception among the gynecologists that it is also the most efficacious agent in menorrhagia. But according to a meta-analysis which was published in the Cochrane Review in 2013, further studies are required to compare individual NSAIDs so that the optimal treatment to reduce menorrhagia can be identified. So our study was designed in such a way that we took mefenamic acid as the standard for controlling menorrhagia in the UV. And for the other hand, we could have chosen any NSAID. We chose diclofenac because in the previous in literature there was no head-on comparison between mefenamic acid and diclofenac. And diclofenac is also very commonly prescribed. And is also present in the essential medicine list. So with that in mind, the priority of the proof of study was to compare the efficacy of mefenamic acid and diclofenac in the menorrhagia patients. And the secondary objective were to compare the analytic effects of mefenamic acid and diclofenac in dysmenorrhea associated with UV, and to study the adverse effects of these two agents in dysfunctional UV. So the materials are better. It was an open-label, randomized, prospective study performed in the gynecological OPD, conducted in the gynecological OPD of Rotterdam Hospital. It was approved by the Institutional Ethics Committee, and all the ethical considerations were taken into account. The diagnosis of DUB was established after detailed clinical examination, and a battery of investigations were performed, like a meeting program, pelvic sonography, aspiration, biopsy, pap smear, etc. Because dysfunctional uterine bleeding is basically a diagnosis of exclusion, so we have to exclude all the other known causes of menorrhagia. So the inclusion criteria was newly diagnosed patients of dysfunctional uterine bleeding with or without dysmenorrhea in the age group of 18 to 40 years. The exclusion criteria were presence of any endometrial or cervical malignancy, pelvic inflammatory disease, any palpable pelvic pathology, or any like fibroids on ultrasonography. If the patient had only one single episode of menorrhagia, she was excluded. Then comorbid conditions like hepatic impairment, coagulation defects, because in hepatic impairment also there is decreased coagulation factor synthesis, so it can also lead to menorrhagia, so these patients were excluded. As long as there were certain cases of, because sometimes NSAIDs can precipitate asthma like an aspirin. The patients using intracranial contraceptive devices, because that is a known side effect of menorrhagia, is a known side effect of these devices. There are no allergies to prostate acid synthesis inhibitors, and patients taking anticoagulant or hormonal treatment. So the psychiatric sample size was 68, and the patients were randomized into two groups of 34 each. The first group was group A, which received mefenamic acid 500 milligrams 3 times a day for 5 days, starting from the first day of menstruation. And the second group was started with diclofenac 50 milligrams volumes of blood. That is the fixed volumes of 15 ml, 30 ml, 50 ml, 100 ml. The patient was shown this chart and she was asked to ask three questions. She was asked to identify which of the pads she used in one day and how many such pads she used in one entire day, and then the number of days for which the bleeding had occurred. So if you multiply the answer to each of these questions, you get the amount of bleeding that occurred in one particular cycle. And the other parameter was number of days of bleeding on this per cycle, which was asked by a simple verbal imagery. The dyslinuria estimation was done by a visual analog scale. A visual analog scale that made the translations and simple figures was used. And the patient was asked to rate the extent of menstrual bleeding from 0 to 10, 0 meaning no pain and 10 meaning recognizing pain. So after the first visit, where all the baseline parameters were taken, and the patient was given the 5-day drug treatment, and she was followed up in the OPD again after a week of the first visit. And after this visit, she was instructed to visit again at the onset of menstruation in the next cycle, and followed up after a week in a similar fashion. And finally, she visited at the onset of menstruation on the third cycle, followed up for the same parameters. So the data was entered and analyzed using GraphPack plus Simon software, and a man with the US was used to compare the data after applying an intention to treat analysis. Last observation carried forward. So in actual, if I just say, 153 patients of hemorrhagic and out of these 71 patients were excluded because in them the diagnosis of DUB could not be then established. And 14 patients declined to be a part of the study. So 68 patients were recruited at the end, and then they were randomized into mefenamic acid and diclofenac groups. In the first cycle, there was a withdrawal of 13 patients, 9 patients from the mefenamic acid group and 4 patients from the diclofenac group. So only those patients who at least provided data for the first follow-up were included in the intention to treat analysis, which means 40-55 patients were included in the ITT. And a p-value of less than 0.05 was considered significant. So coming to the results, the baseline parameters were similar in both the groups. Baseline parameters like age, the menstrual cycle duration, the baseline VAS score, and the median baseline bleeding, they were all statistically insignificant. The main results were that comparing mefenamic acid with diclofenac in terms of hemorrhagia, if you see the median value, both mefenamic acid and diclofenac, they were able to reduce the median bleeding volume from the baseline significantly. But when they were compared to each other, then diclofenac fared better. Diclofenac showed a more significant reduction of the median bleeding volume compared to mefenamic acid. And there was also the number of pads used was also significantly less in diclofenac group compared to mefenamic acid group, and the number of bleeding days was also significantly less in the diclofenac group compared to mefenamic acid group. So this is a figure showing that there was a significant decline in the median bleeding volume with diclofenac, which is shown by the blue line. And then if you see the results with the in patients who had associated dyslinuria, which is a subgroup of this, of the ADNR study. So, visual analog scale score, we see with mefenamic acid and diclofenac, they were individually able to reduce the menstrual pain scores from the baseline significantly, but when they were compared to each other, then there was no significant difference seen in decreasing the menstrual pain scores. So no serious adverse effects were seen in any of the patients. In the mefenamic acid group, the most common adverse effect seen was headache, seen in 3 patients. And in the diclofenac group also, and in the diclofenac group, the most common adverse effect seen was dyspepsia. So coming to the discussion, the median reduction of hemorrhagia with mefenamic acid was 43.38%, and in the previous studies it has been seen that this goes in the range of 40%, which was also our study gave a somewhat similar kind of result. And in our study, the patients with dysmenorrhea showed significant improvement in the pain scores compared to baseline on methylmethionine acid, and this is consistent with the previous studies. So there are a number of studies which have compared methylmethionine acid with other NSAIDs, but in dysmenorrhea. They all have concluded that NSAIDs are more or less equal with as far as dysmenorrhea is concerned. So in conclusion, I would like to say that methylmethionine acid and diclofenac individually managed to significantly reduce the excessive bleeding compared to baseline. And the control of urinary was achieved to a better extent by diclofenac compared to methylmethionine acid. In women who had associated dysmenorrhea, both the agents were found to be equally efficacious. The adverse effects were mild in both the groups, and the major limitation of the study that was needed to see was that the data that it was analyzed, it was non-normally distributed. So we suggest that if at all further studies are done in the future, although the sample size that we used was also calculated, but we need to use a higher sample size so that the results can be more effectively generalized. Also, other insights can be explored in dysfunctional breast feeding to identify the optimum treatment. Thank you.
I have a question. How did you randomize the group?
Drop.
And what are your